very somber Friday here at 8 News Now as we remember a longtime member of our family, Gary Waddell. He passed away Thursday evening. Thank you for joining us. I'm Kirsten Joyce.
And I'm Christian Cáceres. Gary was not only a beloved member of our family, he was a fixture in living rooms across Las Vegas as a main anchor for 32 years. 8 News Now anchor Brian Loftus looks back at the life and legacy of Gary.
During his 32 years at KLAS, Gary Waddell was known for his honesty and calm demeanor on the air and his leadership and mentorship behind the scenes. He spent many of his three decades at the station sitting alongside Paula Francis.
I get it as often as anything else that when bad things are happening, you and Paula make me feel like it's going to be okay.
Denise Valdez, Sue Loudon, and George Knapp on the evening news.
Where news comes first. Now, Gary Waddell.
The newscast, anchored by Gary and George, won UPI's Newscast of the Year in 1986. He was loved by everyone at the station. Gary covered many of the events and moments that left lasting impacts on our city. From the MGM fire in 1980.
The latest reports are that the fire is out.
To the Pepcon chemical explosion.
At this morning's Nevada delegation meeting.
And brought us coverage from national events like the 1996 Democratic Convention in Chicago and following along with Nevada's Task Force One as they rescued people trapped in Louisiana by Hurricane Katrina in 2005. Gary arrived in Las Vegas in 1971 as a TV reporter, moving over to Channel 8 in 1980 until his retirement in 2012.
My favorite line, I think, is Don Hewitt's when he talks about 60 Minutes and the reason for 60 Minutes, and that is tell me a story. And from then to today, that is still the hallmark of this business.
His name will forever be remembered as a respected and iconic journalist in our great city. He was the longest-serving newscaster in Las Vegas history. Gary is in the Nevada Broadcasters Hall of Fame, the KLAS Hall of Fame, won a slew of broadcasting awards, and even has a street named after him. Outside of work, Gary loved riding his motorcycle. He even worked at a Harley shop after he retired. And anyone who stopped by his desk remembers his faithful pet tarantula, Frankie.
I'm really going to miss being in the center of the action when
that's why we're
the
here,
world's
isn't
ending.
It?
You know, I mean, not the world's
no,
ending, but
no.
You know, when something is happening.
Yeah.
And we are going to have much more coverage throughout the afternoon and evening, including a conversation with Paula Francis. Ted, you of course worked with Gary for some time.
Yeah, I think my fondest memory was when I got here in 2004. They put me right at the weather. There was a monsoon storm going.
Yeah.
I couldn't pronounce a Hualapai. I couldn't pronounce Grand Teton. But I was covering weather the best I could. I did a horrible job, right? And then Gary comes over to me after the show. And I was like distraught because I was like, how did I do? And he goes, without a word, just goes, Ted, great job. And you're going to do even better tomorrow.
Aw, thank you for sharing that, Ted.